ओए डम डम डीगा डीगा, ओ डम डम डीगा डीगा, मौसम भीगा भीगा, अजी गिरा मैं तो गिरा, मैं तो गिरा मैं, हाय अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह, मौसम डीगा डीगा। वेट अ मिनट सर, I see somebody walking towards us. It's the Chinese commander from across the yellow sea. Maybe they have run out of toilet paper again and have come to borrow some from us. What do you think? Should we allow him inside? Oh, he's already inside. Well, let him in then. I said that on your behalf. I hope it is the Chinese commander. We wouldn't want to allow the sub-commander. What? Are Maya? I mean, are Bhaiya? It's not the Chinese commander. It's the Chinese sub-commander. Don't you see that flat hat he's wearing? That's the sub-commander's hat. Unless he has stolen the sub-commander's hat, because his own hat was taken off and shred to pieces by his dog, Ting. Ting is a dangerous dog. What does he want now? These Chinese must not be allowed to come across repeatedly across the Macmahon line. It's the only line we have got. It's the Lakshman Rekha. For these Chinese, let them stay where they have been asked to stay, in China. Hello, how are you? How are you, sir? What have you come to borrow this time? We don't have toilet paper either. We use water. Sorry, we don't have toilet paper. Is that what you have come to ask for once again? Because during these days of friendship, you always ask for toilet paper. And when the war goes on, then you go on without toilet paper. Right? Then you don't need toilet paper. Because your entire camp becomes a toilet. When our Indian guns start firing into the camp. To make it into a toilet. Then you use your own uniforms to clean yourselves, which is why your uniforms smell of human dung all the time. So, Mr. Ming, Mr. Hung Too Soon, what can I do for you and why have you come here?
Indian commander, Latar Batar Singh, I have come to congratulate you. It is a very good day today. I have come to congratulate you because it is the birthday of the founder of China, Mao Zedong. So you should be happy. So today we will not cross. Across the Macmahon line, sorry. You can cross it and come here if you like. We are throwing a party of noodles. Noodles and needles. Whichever you prefer. What? Do you accept our invitation? Or do you accept our invitation? There are only two alternatives. If you don't accept our invitation, then the third invitation is from you to us, that you invite us over the Macmahon line, and together in your Indian side of the Macmahon line, we celebrate Mao Zedong's birthday. How is that? Well, what better day in the world could there be than the birthday of Mao Zedong? Yes, we Indians are very hospitable, and our hospitals are just as good as our hospitality. So, we invite you into our, well, we don't invite you, you are already invited in, right? You are in without invitation. You are already here. So, right, we invite you. We don't want, who wants to eat that tasteless Chinese food of noodles and chow mein and mei chow and momos, Chinese momos? No, we give you the proper food to eat on such an auspicious occasion, sacred occasion, the birthday of Chairman Mao, who is no longer alive, but his chair is still there. So, we say to you, we treat you to halwa and puris. What do you think, Mr. Halwa? Have we got any halwas? Oh, sorry, Mr. Torbatar Singh, have we got any halwas? What? That's what we eat every day. So that makes things easier. Halwas and puris. So we wish to treat you to halwa and puri. And once you have eaten halwa and puri, you would wish you were born in India. You would wish you had never eaten chow mein and Chinese noodles. Right? It would have been better if you had eaten the chopsticks instead. Your food tastes like chopsticks. Whenever I eat Chinese food with chopsticks, I throw the food away and eat the chopsticks. And then, it makes my teeth stronger if they don't fall out. So do you accept our invitation to celebrate the birthday of Chairman Mao? He is such a great man, Mao's thoughts. Mao's thoughts. You know what Mao's thoughts are. I remember reading Mao's thoughts on Google Internet. You can also read them. Go to Google and see. And there, look up the word fart, F-A-R-T, fart. And then you hear Mao's thoughts, read Mao's thoughts. Do you know what Chairman Mao said? A loud fart in Parliament is better than a long speech. What? What is a loud fart? A loud fart is a fart that is loud. What is a fart? You don't know what is a fart? A fart is the passing of wind. Passing of wind through your body. Passing out of wind. Right? That is known as a fart. The sound it makes. It's like a helicopter. Right? How would that be? Mr. Torbatar Singh, our friend, the Chinese comrade, does not even know the meaning of Mao's thoughts. Mao said, a loud fart in Parliament is better than a long speech. And he wants to know what is the sound of a fart. Okay, so Mr. Torbatar Singh, why don't you give him the sound of a fart? I think you've got a tape recording of a sound of a fart. You downloaded it from an internet. So, play it for him on your walkie-talkie. Mobile, sorry. Wow! Beautiful! Wonderful! Wonderful! Wonderful.
The last part frightened me, but it was good, very good. So that is a loud fart. No, that was not a loud fart. That was a long fart. A loud fart is like an atom bomb. It's so loud, it shatters your eardrums. That is why all the members of parliament of Mao Zedong were deaf, because of his loud farts in parliament, where everybody's eardrums went out of their ears. Anyway, thank you for the demonstration. Thank you. And after hearing a sound like that, a wonderful sound like that, it fills your stomach with rotations that make you want to eat. You want to eat more and more food. So where are the puris and the halwa you were about to give us? Give us the puris and the halwas. Now we are hungry after listening to such a wonderful sound. Music with food. And now while we eat, you can play that recording of the fart throughout. Music to celebrate. Fart music. Wonderful Chinese. Wonderful. Where did you get that sound file? Oh, you downloaded it from a Chinese website. Oh, that's it. They've got a lot of farts to accompany Mao's thoughts. Okay. So, bring on the halwas and the puris. And then we will have more of Mao's thoughts. Oh, thank you. Can I eat it? Are you sure it is not poison? You're sure? It's not poison? Then you should eat it. We like poisoned halwa. I was just joking. Okay, wonderful. So I start eating the halwa and the puris. So you sing, Ming Tong sing, song long, song. Thank you for the puris and the halwa. And now, ladies and gentlemen, sorry, Mr. Latar Batar Singh and Mr. Tor Batar Singh, Indian commander, I have a wonderful proposal to make that will bring peace on the Macmahon line forever. This puris and these halwas was so delicious. And we Chinese are so good at copying Japanese made things. You must have learned how to make puris and halwas in Japan, right? Everybody copies Japan, and then China copies what everybody has copied from Japan. So we are going to copy puris and halwas also. But this is so delicious that it is my intention that I and all my men, how many men have I got? 50 million. I and 50 million of my men
across the Macmahon line who are daily clashing with Indian troops, and there is war, right? War and fighting for no reason at all, except that we don't know where the Macmahon line is. That idiot Macmahon probably let out a long fart instead of drawing the line properly. So what I have decided, all of us, I and my troops, 50 million troops and I, we are immigrating to India to settle down in India. That way all fighting will cease. There will be permanent peace, and all of us Chinese will open a chain of restaurants. Ping Poorees and Hing Halwas. And we will call this chain of restaurants Mao's Farts. How's that? Better than McDonald's? Right? Mao's Farts. That'll be the chain of restaurant we'll open all over India. And all of us will settle down in India. There will be no need to invade India, right? Why invade India when we can go there and prepare Poorees and Halwas for the Indians? They will enjoy the Poorees and Halwas. We will enjoy India. What a wonderful thing. And we can forget about the Macmahon line. Blow up the Macmahon line right now if you like, right? So now it's time for us to apply for immigration visas. And even if you don't have, and do you have an office for illegal immigration? Well, we'd like to go there, right? Thank you for the Poorees and the Halwas, and thank you for the loud, long fart.